Hi, welcome to structure section. Today we're going to discuss about conjunction as a part of speech in English. Make sure that you watch and learn because remember that we're always going to have a challenge at the end of the video. So let's check it out. We're going to discuss about the definitions of conjunction first. So what is conjunction? Conjunction used to join words, phrases, and clauses in a sentence. So conjunction is the glue that holds words, phrases, and clauses together. So especially on clauses, the clauses it's called as dependent and independent. Jadi conjunction adalah kata yang digunakan untuk merekatkan atau merangkai dua kata, dua frase, ataupun dua klausa atau lebih dalam satu kalimat. Khusus untuk klausa, maka klausa yang direkatkan adalah klausa dependent dan independent. Okay? This is conjunction in sentence. Sentence number one. I ate the pizza and the pasta. And as the mark read, is the link of the word the pizza and the pasta. Sentence number two. Call the movers when you are ready. So when is linked or glue. Call the movers and you are ready. Okay, about the further explanations about conjunction, we're going to discuss it on the next slides. Kinds of a conjunction. There are three conjunctions. First is coordinating conjunction. The second is correlative conjunction. And the last, subordinating conjunction. First conjunction that we are going to discuss is coordinating conjunction. So what is coordinating conjunction? You use a coordinating conjunction such as and, but, or, nor, for, so, or yet to join individual words, phrases, and independent clauses. For you, as a note, that you can also use the conjunction but and for as a preposition. Here are the coordinating conjunction, the kinds of words, and the function of each word, and also the example of the word in a sentence. We start from number one, for. For is explain reason or purpose, just like because. As an example, I go to the park every Sunday, for I love to watch the duck on the lake. So for in this case, it's coordinating I go to the park every Sunday and the reason why or because I love to watch the duck on the lake. The second, add one thing to another. For the word and, okay, as an example, I watch the duck on the lake and the shirtless man playing soccer. So there are two things. First thing is I watch the duck on the lake, and the second thing is the shirtless man playing soccer. So there are two things that happen at the same time. Nor. Nor is used to present an alternative negative idea to already stated negative idea. Example in a sentence, I don't go for the fresh air, nor for the duck. I just like soccer. So both I don't go for the fresh air and for the duck is something that you don't like. It's something that negative. Both of them is negative. You don't like it and you don't have it. Some things that you like it is I just like soccer. Okay. But shows contrast. Soccer is entertaining in winter, but it's better in the heat of summer. So but is contrasting between soccer in entertaining in winter and it's better in heat of summer, in the heat of summer. So these two clauses are contrasted together, berlawanan. Coordinating conjunction or present an alternative or a choice. The men play on two teams, shirt or skin. So it is the alternative or a choice between the shirt and the skin. Yet, introduce a contrasting idea that follows the preceding idea logically. I always take a book to read, yet I never seem to turn a single page. So it is something that contrasting. I also take a book to read is contrasting with I never seem to turn a single page. So it means that even though that you claim that you are reading, but you don't reading. Okay, you don't read anything. So indicate effect, result or consequence. I'm dating one of the players, so I watch the soccer game each week. So I'm dating one of the player. It's indicate the result because you are watching the soccer game each week. So you are dating it because you watch it every week, maybe because you like it, so you dating one of the player. Second conjunction is subordinating conjunction. A subordinating conjunction introduced a dependent class or clause and indicated the nature of a relationship among the independent clauses and dependent clauses. So the most common subordinating conjunction are after, although, as, because, before, how, if, once, since, then, that, though, till, until, when, where, whether, and while. So this is the kinds of word of a coordinate subordinate conjunction, the function and the example of it. Number one, although, mean in spite of the fact that. Example, although it was raining, I ran home. So although mean in spite of the fact, walaupun gitu. After, so subsequently to the time when. I always tell my daughter that she can have dessert after she eats her dinner. So it's consequently or subsequently because you are doing something. So when you're doing something, you are going to have something after it. So I always tell my daughter that she can have the dessert. Subsequently, he going to have after it, after I tell it, she eat the dinner because I tell it. Okay. Before. So's earlier than the time that. I need to finish the report before the manager arrived from Paris. So the word before shows something happened earlier than the time. I need to finish the report. It happened earlier. And the deadline is the manager arrived from Paris. So you have to do something before the manager arrive, which is finish the report. Because means for the reason that he become rich because he was smart and work hard. So because is the reason that something happened. So he become rich is the reason is because he was smart and work hard. How means the way in which. Berarti bagaimana caranya? Tell me how you persuade Danny to see that film. Katakan bagaimana caranya kamu mempengaruhi Danny untuk melihat film. How berarti bagaimana caranya? If means if the moment that. If I receive a promotion, you will be the first to know. Jika ya, momen itu terjadi atau event itu terjadi yaitu mendapatkan promosi, maka dia akan menjadi orang yang pertama tahu. Jika seandainya momen itu terjadi. Once indicate at the moment when. Once you see you will recognize him. So ketika ya Anda melihat dia, Anda akan mengenalinya. Since, from the time when. Since, from the time when. Sejak. Sejak itu terjadi. This shop has been refurbished 3 times since I live here. Jadi, toko ini sudah direnov 3 kali sejak saya ada di sini, hidup di sini. So, in order to, so that she could keep her job, she didn't complain at all. So, in this case, mean because she want to keep her job, that's why she didn't complain. Karena ingin dia tetap bekerja, maka dia tidak complain. Maka atau jadi. Until means up to the time that. She didn't know she was a talented singer until she sang in the school concert. Until means sampai gitu. Dia tidak tahu dia berbakat sampai dia bernyanyi di konser sekolah. Unless mean except on the condition. I will not tell you anything unless you tell me what you know first. Kecuali, saya nggak akan bilang apa-apa kecuali kamu bilang apa yang kamu ketahui terlebih dahulu. When means at the time. I start looking for a place to stay when I decided I want to live here. Ketika saya itu memutuskan untuk tinggal di sini, maka saya mencari tempat tinggal. It's a correlative conjunction. Correlative conjunction always appear in pairs. So you use them to link equivalent sentence elements. The most common correlative conjunction are both and, either or, neither nor, not only, but also, so, as, and, whether, or. Technically, correlative conjunction consists simple of coordinating conjunction linked to adjective or adverb. Jadi, correlative conjunction ini selalu terdiri dari dua kata yang menghubungkan dua hal yang sama. Jadi, biasanya misalnya menghubungkan adjective dan adverb. Begitu. Subordinate conjunction, both blah 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 and connect either two subject or two object, menghubungkan dua objek ataupun dua subjek. Both John and Lauren enjoy the movie. Jadi dia menghubungkan dua subjek yaitu John and Lauren. As blah 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 as compare nouns using an adjective or adverb. Menghubungkan dua kata benda yang menggunakan adjective ataupun adverb. A lion can run fast as a cheetah. Dua kata benda yang dimaksud adalah lion dan cheetah. Nah, yang dihubungkan adalah run fast, yaitu adjective dan adverb fast. Yang dibandingkan atau compare. Not only blah blah blah, but also can connect noun or entire clauses. Jadi not only but also itu menghubungkan dua kata benda ataupun keseluruhan klause. I'm not only going to the concert, but I also meeting the band backstage. Jadi yang dihubungkan itu atau yang disambungkan adalah I'm not only going to the concert. Not I am going to the concert dan I am meeting the band backstage. I am going to the concert dan I am meeting the backstage. Whether or link to infinitive phrases, menghubungkan dua frase. I didn't know whether you'd want the cheesecake or the chocolate cake. Jadi frasenya adalah cheesecake dan chocolate cake. Ya, you'd want the cheesecake atau the chocolate cake. So that's all about the explanations about conjunction. Make sure you do the challenge of making a sentence that consists of the conjunction and explain what kinds of a conjunction is it and what is the function of the conjunction is it. Okay, promise me to do the challenge at the comment section below. Okay guys, thank you for today. Thank you for listening to the video. I think that's all for today. We're going to see you on the next video. Okay, see you. Bye.